Welcome, folks, to another Gamehorder Annual Collection DOS Game Update. We are here for 2013. As you can see, we're still at four shelves. The collection has not grown that much at all. The reasoning behind that is a website called Kickstarter. I've invested several thousand dollars into Kickstarter at this point, and as those games start coming in, I'll be doing basically demos of the boxes, what rewards and perks I received, and of course LPing the game shortly thereafter once I've gotten a chance to play through it and beat it on my own time. Or I might just do some blind LPs for once. That's something that I'm not known for. I tend to kind of get in after I've already played through the game once, twice, maybe thrice, and then get in there and whoop its ass. Just to kind of show you guys a walkthrough version of it with, of course, my omnipotent narrative powers. Okay, so let's get into it. You're going to notice some new things. I'm going to just pretend this is the first collection video I've done and kind of pull out my favorites, things I've LP'd, things I want to LP, things like that. Everyone say hi to my Lug doll in the Gamehorder first original design Gamehorder t-shirt. He sits over here and watches and talks to me while I work on the computer. We might even get into a bit. My office is in a bit disarray, but this is actually, I'm actually at work right now on my lunch break shooting this, so that's what it looks like when I work. I got my computer down here, the beast. I'm putting in some new fans. Then I have my other computer over here. This is another one I built. This is the one Gamehorder plays on. Got a picture of me and Mom's on the wall. She's got the 27-inch ViewSonic monitor, and I'm busting out with the 30-inch Mac monitor because I'm pimp. And I got some THX certified Logitech speakers. They're kind of old school. Got my printers over here, Epson Workforce. And I also got an HP Touch Smart. So anyways, back to what the video is all about. The collection. Revenant. Awesome game, man. I can't wait to LP this. It's one of these trapezoid type boxes. Very interesting. The Horde. Cool strategy game. I might actually get into doing this eventually. Stonekeep, definitely going to be LPing this, hopefully sometime this year or next. I got the very cool reflective holographic image box. Also came with a little hardback novella. Chenty, my buddy Chenty, sent me the Z box for Gabriel Knight. It now sits atop on the exotic box shelf. We have good old Pool of Radiance. Runes of Mithdrenor, what a shitty game. I'll probably LP it just so you guys can hear me curse the entire time. And the Warcraft 3 Collector's Edition. We got Cyber Mage, which was a cool, kind of cool, comic-type first-person game that Origin did. It's upside down. Comes with a little comic book in there. Ultima Collection. I'm missing Ultima 1 and 2. Hard to get a hold of those, as you can imagine. I look on eBay from time to time. Again, Kickstarter's kind of broke me at this point. Plus, for those that don't know, I just recently became engaged. So, yeah, engagement rings aren't cheap, and especially this one. So got Ultima 3, 4, 5. Got Ultima 6. Let me close my fan. I'm sorry if you're getting AC blown into the speakers there. Ultima 6 Sealed. This game's very important to me. I don't know if I've ever mentioned this, but this is a game that my grandmother bought me back when I was very young. It's one of the first, I think the first true epic RPG I played on my computer. And I remember one day my mom was calling me to go to Boy Scouts, and I didn't want to leave. I just found the fucking Cyclops cave, and I wanted to explore that motherfucker and decapitate some Cyclopses. And I'll never forget that night. I still went to Scouts, but when I got home, I busted up the Ultima 6 on my old 286 12 megahertz with the turbo button that ramped it up to 14 megahertz. Beat that, motherfucker. Got the complete Ultima 7 here with the Serpent Isle. Pagan CD edition. Ultima Underworld 1 and 2 CD edition. I've thought about getting these in separate boxes, but honestly, the CD editions of these old DOS games are the best ones. It's got all the bugs were fixed at that point, well, most of them. You got the voice. So I always try to get the CD-ROM edition. This is the CD-ROM collection. Savage Empire, Ultima Martian Dreams. Definitely, if you haven't seen my LP of the Savage Empire, go ahead and check that out. I got the clue book for this and Martian Dreams recently, which are both very rare. Still going to LP this here in the near future. As well as, of course, all the Ultimas. All the Ultimas will be LP'd eventually. Bioforge, crazy type mech game. Cyber mech action puzzle type game. I'll probably LP that. That's not a very commonly known one. As well as I'll be LPing both the Crusader games. These are really cool action-y type games where you just go around blowing shit up. Continuing along the line of my origin games, I have a System Shock 1 clue book, but I need the System Shock 1 and 2 game. This is a sealed Silver Seed expansion for Ultima 7 Part 2. This is a sealed, though ripping sealed, Knights of Legend. I definitely want to LP this at some time. It's an immensely in-depth RPG game. Same with Times of Lore. This here in the Saran Wrap is Tunnels and Trolls. I just never fully unpacked it. Another old school RPG. King's Bounty, this was the original Heroes of Might and Magic. If you're wondering and I haven't explained or you haven't heard, I keep rubber bands around some of the games as the boxes bend and bow outward. It kind of helps reshape them. I have the I Have Mouth, No Mouth and But Scream game completely sealed. This is worth quite a lot of money. Goes for a couple hundred bucks on eBay. This is the Civ Collector's Edition, Civ 3. The tin Collector's Edition. Chinchy also sent me some other stuff, as well as my buddy Rick Becker. He gave me the Wing Commander 1. Chinchy had sent me the Wing Commander 2 Deluxe Edition. This here is the Star Citizen card that I got. Let's see. I got it wrapped up, so it's kind of hard to see. But anyways, we'll get into that when the game comes out. I'll pull that out. But this is the first Kickstarter item I've actually received. And it's a brushed metal, basically ID card for the Star Citizen game that Chris Roberts is releasing, I believe next year or the year after. It's going to take a while. It's pretty epic. Wing Commander 3, Armada, Privateer is sealed. Wing Commander Prophecy, both versions, the Deluxe and Standard Privateer 2. Wing Commander 4, and then a sealed Kilrathi Saga. This goes for about $300-$400, sometimes even $500 on eBay. It's a pretty epic little piece. This is every Wing Commander that was released, 1, 2, and 3. Well, 1, 2, and 3. And then Wing Commander 4 owners includes a free upgrade patch for the Windows 95. But yeah, that's pretty epic. That's also got, of course, all the expansions. Even's got a little Kilrathi calendar that comes with it. Moving back down to the LucasArts line of things, we have the Classic Adventures. This was a big box one that came out with Monkey Island, Indie, Last Crusade, Loom, Maniac Mansion, Zack McCracken. Down here I got my little The Cave characters. Purchased all those from Double Fine Adventures when The Cave was released. Still trying to get through all the different characters in that game. Got the Telltale Monkey Island collectors. All the Monkey Islands, Grim Fandango, of course, going to LP that relatively soon. Loom recently did that. Of course, Sam and Max and the other LucasArts games. X-Wing, that'd be fun. Have the Might and Magic 1 here. This is a sealed Might and Magic 2. Might and Magic 3, 4 and 5, Clouds and Dark Scene, and then the combination turned into World of Xeen. Have all the hint books for all these, by the way. Including Might and Magic 6, 7, 8. Someone asked me why Might and Magic 9 is down over in the new box games. Well, I keep all the new modern boxes by themselves. They aren't allowed near the classic DOS box games. They fucking are not even allowed to touch them. Because I don't need the new modern boxes corrupting my old bat-ass classic shit. Anvil of Dawn. Got Heroes 3 and 4 down here. This is Heroes 1 and 2 in a box Shanti had sent me. Legend of Carania Trilogy, Lanzalore 1, 2, and 3, and some Command & Conquer games. Down here we have Altered Destiny with the Elvira Trilogy, I like to call it, of our 1 and 2 with Waxworks, Star Control Trilogy. Barb's Tale 2, still looking to get one. I got a sealed Dragon Wars And I also have a opened Dragon Wars that has the clue book inside. That's the old Battle Chess style box that Interplay released. This is Dungeon Master 1 and 2. Got both the clue books for them. Blackthorn's a cool little early Interplay slash Blizzard. One of the first games Blizzard had a part in. That's a cool little action 2D side-scrolling type game. Realms of the Haunting, I've done that. Frankenstein. And Fallout, the early Fallout trilogy, 1, 2, and Tactics. Descent to Under Mountain, I probably will never LP that. That game is complete garbage. Also have a later release sealed Battle Chess. A lot of these games were also donated by my wonderful friend, Jay the Classic Gamer. Make sure you check out his channel. I got Draken with the clue book. This has still got the free fantasy miniature inside. I definitely am going to LP that at some point. Same with Vampire the Masquerade. Zax. This is a crazy little alien shooter game. Lemmings. That'd be fun to LP. Rex Nebula. I've already LP'd that. It's a space questy type point-and-click adventure. Darklands. Plan on LPing. Got Masters of Magic. Still need Masters of Orion. And this is the XCOM trilogy here. Syndicate Wars. I still would like to get an original Syndicate 1 box. And I definitely wouldn't mind LPing that. And Dungeon Keeper. And Sanitarium. Cool little asylum type point-and-click game. Then, of course, we have the Sierra games. No need to introduce or get into depth with them. King's Quest. The Space Quest. I still need Space Quest 6. The Police Quest. I don't really get into SWAT afterwards. Here's the Quest for Glory slash the original Hero Quest game. This is before, of course, the board game company with the same name tried to sue Sierra, and they had to change the name. And I have a somewhat sealed Goblins, and I recently also got the Quest for Glory Shadows of Darkness, which is many people's favorite of the four there. Got the Leisure Suit Larry 1. I still need that's 2. I still need Leisure Suit Larry 1. I got 2 and 3. They never made a 4. There's 5, and I still need 6 as well. Sylphide, Stellar 7. Conquest of Camelot. I still need Conquest of the Longbow. So Sarian, Lexicross, Gold Rush, Codename Iceman, Heart of China, Cardinal's Bequest. I still need Beneath a Steel Sky, but I am going to be working on an LP of that here shortly. Manhunter 1 and 2 is sealed. Zilliard, that's also sealed. And Willie Beamish. Let's go back down here for now. We got the SSI box games. Dragons of the Flame. Hillsfar is sealed. Here's the Lance is sealed. I got an open and a sealed Dragon Strike. Gateway to the Savage Frontier. I got 2 Treasures of the Savage Frontier. This one's sealed. All the clue books, most of them, a lot of those clue books I have are sealed, but I have all of them. That's the Sealed Eye of the Beholder. That's the Trilogy, Shadow Sorcerer, Prophecy of the Shadows, Collector's Edition of Kryn Games. Dungeon Hack, Fantasy Empires, both the Buck Rogers games, second one is sealed. Legends of Valor, still got the plastic. Dark Legion's a cool little strategy type chess game. I've of course LP'd Veil of Darkness and the Summoning. And then we have the big box SSI games, Stone Prophet, Menzo Baranzan, Straw Possession, Dark Zone 1 and 2, which I'm working on now, and a Archive Civil Edition. Down here we have the Age of Mythology Collectors, the Warcraft Originals 1 and 2, Sacrifice, the original Elder Scroll Arena, which this and of course Daggerfall, they go for a ton of money. I actually got the clue book in there as well. I got the Morrowind Collector's Edition with the clue book. Stunt Island was a cool game I used to play with, where you could create and build all these little tracks and shit with different planes and cars. Dark Age of Camelot, one of the earlier MMORPGs that was actually good. Gorosul, a lot of people haven't heard of this. This is kind of a action Diablo-ish RPG. Probably do an LP of that eventually. Everyone knows Mortal Kombat. Got some simulator games. LucasArts Archive, Half-Life, Longest Journey, which I just started uploading some videos of that today. Time Commando, these are just some other bullshit games. Nothing really great down there. And then, of course, the How'd You Get Out of the Toilet? Ultima 9, biggest piece of dog shit game. And then Diablo 1, 2, the Collector's Edition, as well as Hellfire. I'll go ahead and stay down here on the floor. We've got Daughters of the Serpents, Battletech. This is Ween the Prophecy. I just left it in the bubble wrap. I'm moving soon, so I didn't unwrap everything. Castle of the Winds 2 sealed. I'm working on getting a copy of 1. Twinson's Odyssey, Subterra Core. BLP in that. Magic Candle 1, 2, and 3. BLP in all 3 of those. This is the original Wizardries 1 and 2. I don't have 3 yet. Still working on it. This is 1, 2, and 4. These go for quite a lot of money as well. I'll be LPing the entire Wizardries shortly. Bane of the Cosmic Forge. And then I have the Wizardry Gold there. Wizardry 7. Realms of Arcania. They're actually remaking these from what I understand. This is a sealed 3 and a still in plastic 1. Missing 2. Some other games you may or may not have heard of. This Legend of Fargal. Probably LP that at some point. Crime Wave, one of the earliest first computer games I ever played. Actually, it was the first. That and Battle Chess were the first 2 games I had for my PC. That's sealed, and I got a sealed Ghost and Goblins. Love that game. Wizard Wars, the other first game that I had for my PC. My old 286. And then we got games that no one's ever heard of. Trilogy, Demon's Tomb, Night Games, Demon's Forge. These are kind of old school little picture text adventure games. We'll get around to doing all of it. Got Freddy Farkas. Got ripped off on eBay and bought a dumbass Dagger of Amun-Ra box that was taped onto the box. You can see it's not the original. Mother Goose, which I LP'd for Jay the Classic Gamer. And I got the original box for the Black Cauldron in there as well. Outpost. This is a Gabriel Knight CD-ROM sealed edition I recently picked up. This is the non-Z-Box version, obviously. Feels pretty light. Gabriel Knight 2 and 3, Shivers 1 and 2. Still need the original Betrayal at Krondor. Homeworld, Throne of Darkness, which is a Diablo-ish samurai-type game, and Arcanum. Up here we got some other shit. Other games that I used to play. Keith the Thief, this is a sealed version. Harvester. For some reason, people love this wickedly fucked up game. Populous was another game I used to love, a little world building game. This is the 2 other games I'm really looking forward to LPing is Vengeance of Excalibur and Spirit of Excalibur. Kind of a mix of RPG, puzzle, adventure, everything. Really crazy. Got Discworld here. Still needing to get the other Discworld. This is the original. Got the book for that as well. It's a really nice condition. SimCity, which is another copy. This is the earlier edition they made before they came out with this one. Some other games, Guy Spy. It's a Don Bluth type game like Dragon's Lair and Space Ace. Dominus, Punisher, Civ 2, 11th Hour. Going to be LPing 7th Guest in 11th Hour at some point. This is the Fable adventure game by Sirtech that I've already LP'd. Knights of Zentar, pretty cool little RPG Jap. There's a disc that unlocks it to make the chick shirtless, which is kind of funny. Megatech also made this Metal Lace. It's kind of a Street Fighter type game. And then we have the Legend series, basically. I pretty much have the entire Legend collection. Sorcerers, Spellcasting 101, 201, 301. The Wheel of Time game they made based off the Robert Jordan books, first person. It's kind of cool. Time Quest. This is sealed, although the seal is getting a bit loose. This is a sealed Gateway. This is Gateway 2. Complete. This is Death Gate. I've done this. This is another series of books by Margaret Wise, Tracy Hickman. Awesome books, awesome game. Companions of Xanth, which I've done, also based off the Piers Anthony novels. Another game I really am looking forward to LPing is Superhero League Hoboken. This is a really rare find for me. I love having this game. It's crazy, kind of like a wizardry type game, except like comics and superheroes and just all kinds of shit. It's fucking awesome. And I don't think anyone's ever LP'd it. Eric the Unready. This is a sealed version. Still got the $59.95 label. Our price, $14.88. Shannara. This is as well sealed, based off the Terry Brooks novels. And this is a sealed Callahan's Cross Time Saloon, based off the Spider Robinson books. My Carmen Sandiego games. Myth, pretty cool strategy game. The original Worms. A sealed New York Warriors, which is a lot like Akari Warriors overhead Contra type game. Powermonger, which is basically like Populous. Ultimate Domain, this is the Wolfenstein, Spear of Destiny, a sealed 3D Wolfenstein, Corridor 7, Dooms and Quakes. Of course, up here we have my beloved Baldur's Gates, Icewind Dales, Planescape Torments. And then we have my StarCraft guy here. And we have StarCraft 2, and I have the StarCraft 2 collectors still sealed, and behind that is the collectors for 1. I haven't got around to playing it yet. Got the World of Warcraft collection, Diablo's collection up here. Everyone loves Blizzard after all that mess. Amnesia. Famous little horror game there. I'll be LPing one day. Got the Unwritten Tales, Critter Chronicles. There's Broken Sword 1 and 2. Probably get the old school boxes for those eventually. This is Command & Conquer the First Decade. 12 Command & Conquer games wrapped into one. Some more Command & Conquers. Commandos, this is a badass game. I'll end up LPing eventually. Cool strategy. Same with Company of Heroes. This is the tin version. Steelbook version. City of Villains, suck dick. This is a sealed Sid Meier's Chronicles. Civilization 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then Civilization 4. Crisis 1 and 2. Dawn of War, Deponia, Chains of Satanav, which I'll be LPing eventually. Dishonored, I've already done. Dark Messiah, Might and Magic, Divinity, be doing all the Divinities. Dragon Age 1 and 2, be doing both of those. Dungeon Siege 1 and 2, and expansions, I'll be doing those, as well as the Elder Scrolls. Fallout. I have all the Fallout 3 collector's editions, but they're on Xbox. Back in my Xbox heyday. Galactic Civilization, this is a really kick-ass sci-fi game. Very Star Control-ish and FTL-ish. Gothic 1, 2, and 3. Harbinger, it's kind of a mech Diablo game. Heroes of Might and Magic 5. I'll probably do the Heroes of Might and Magic series one day. New King's Bounty. Jade Empire by BioWare. The shitty, shitty Leisure Suit Larry Magnum Cum Laude. That's just a fucking disgrace to Al Lowe. I should actually throw that in the toilet. Lionheart. This game sucks. Dreamfall. It's a sequel to The Longest Journey. Machinarium. It's a cool little adventure puzzle game. Some robots. My Magic 9 will be doing all the Neverwinter Nights eventually. Got to get back into my painkiller. Got Supreme Commander down there. Some Spellforce Soldiers. Silent Storm's a really cool game. There's the newer Sam & Max's Sacred. Quake 4, Rise of Nations. Siberia 1 and 2. Richard Garriott's shitty-ass Tabula Rasa. Probably end up doing a Titan Quest LP eventually. Byron's got a pretty good one out there right now. Definitely will be doing the Temple of Elemental Evil soon. Trine 1 and 2. Another adventure game I mean to do pretty soon is the Vampire Story. There's a Kickstarter project going on Kickstarter right now for a prequel series, but it's not doing too well. Also got this box set of World in Conflict. And then we have The Witcher 1 and 2, which I'm definitely looking forward to doing both of those. And Zoo Tycoon and XCOM, which XCOM I kind of gave up on because it was so fucking hard. Bitches kept dying and shit. So anyways, that is the update for the 2013 collection. I want to thank you for watching, and I need to get back to LP. Oh, one last thing, because I never have ever have shown these here. Some of the other games that I just have in CD cases. Without the boxes, I got Hexen. This is Master Levels for Doom 2. Final Doom. Seville, which is a
quirky adventure game. Serious Sam Gold. Age of the Empires. Hunter and Hunted. I have the Lord of the Rings Valueware versions. Two Towers. Kohan, which is a little a deluxe box set here. This is the original Galactic Civilization. And then those are just some other CDs, not games.
So yeah, that's pretty much it. And stay tuned for 2014. Hopefully I got some good Kickstarter stuff to add to the collection by then. Thanks for watching, folks.